You know, I used to get like bullied in high school. That's how I started picking up
Even I
my
got bullied.
camera.
Even I got bullied in high school, but I didn't become a celebrity photographer. Hey guys, thanks for tuning in. We're going to be talking to Sasha Jayaram, a fashion and fine art photographer. Hi Dharna. Hi Tanya. Hi Nandan. What's up, bro? Just trying to wait for Sasha to join us. Hi.
Oh my God. I've never done
that. What up?
What's up? How's it going?
Huh? It's going, man. It's going. How's it going for you? Before I even introduce you, everyone, she's found the nicest place in the house with natural light coming on her face. Look at that photographer.
Light everywhere.
Oh, okay. When I do lives, I find like a
but
dark
right.
corner which no one can disturb. I go and do the live over there.
Yeah. What's up?
What's up? Okay, so to everyone who's watching, this is Sasha Jayaram. She's a fashion and fine art photographer. Sasha, tell us a little bit about yourself.
That's
before
what you
we
just
start.
Said. About what? Ask me something, na?
So you're a photographer, right? How did you get into photography? Did you know from the moment you were born and like your parents were taking pictures of you?
No, not really. So basically, I wanted to be a jewelry designer. That was
okay.
my primary plan. But then I knew I was good at taking pictures on the phone as well, you know. So there was like, I used to change my profile picture in high school, like changing underwear, basically. But like, you know, I used to get like, bullied in high school. That's how I started picking up
Even I got bullied in high school, but I didn't become a celebrity photographer.
And one of my friends got selected for Miss India through my pictures.
Riddhi said no one bullied you in school. Don't lie. Riddhi, you don't even remember me in school. Don't talk. When she was on live, she was like, honestly, I don't remember you seeing you in school. Okay, yeah. So you were telling us that you were just casually taking pictures of your friends and then she got selected for a modeling competition, right?
No, Miss India.
Miss India. Okay, sorry. I don't know much about all these things. I may make a few bloopers. So then what happened?
Then I started. So basically, I went to uni after that. And then...
Where do you go to school?
I took uni.
Uni, yeah.
I went to Condé Nast College of Fashion and Design.
Ooh, is that
and
in London?
Yeah. Fashion, media and communication. So photography was a part of my course. For my final project, I did good photography. And in BIS, I took art out of...
Ooh, there was...
I only passed art. Huh?
And there was a photography teacher, I remember, in BIS.
Yeah. Frank.
He was good.
Yeah.
So, guys, we went to the school. Oh, that's, yeah. Let's see, we have some questions coming up. So
that's the only... I realized I was good with photography also because I failed all my subjects in BIS except photography.
Okay.
So that was also one of the signs.
So basically the point is you don't have to like get good grades to become successful later and to kill in photography and stuff, right?
It's all about your personality.
Because I was looking at your website also. You have a dope freaking website, first of all. I was like stalking my subject.
It's not updated. It's not updated.
It's fine. It's fine.
Ages.
The thing that I love the most about it is that somewhere you say... you say two things. One, you're grateful to your parents, and one that you don't need to have qualifications in order to be a good photographer, which I respect. The hustle. Okay, so before we get into more things to get to know you and about your cool life, Vikram says, "Hey Sasha, welcome to the Hub Live. What's your go-to
What's your go-to camera and lens?" What I use is Canon Mark II 1D, and my favorite lens is 85mm f1.2.
Okay, everyone, you heard that. Please make a note. Just for this one, I'm going to try this because you've been doing some cool photography projects. Okay. Okay, so before we go more into it, and I want to ask you about the FaceTime photography thing you're doing. But before that, quickly, just to like warm up, I'm going to ask you a couple of silly questions so that everyone can get to know who you are.
I don't know why I'm sweating.
Yeah, yeah, because you're in the sun. Who told you to go in for go for natural
light? Not the sun. It's basically, I've never done live videos.
Okay, I'm so happy you're doing it with us. Thank you for that. We're taking everyone's live virginity on this
only
on this channel.
Yeah.
Okay. Movies or TV shows?
Right now?
Forever.
I'm watching Prison Break all over again.
No. Would you, if you could only pick movies or TV shows, which one do you like better?
I don't have the patience for a TV show.
Okay, so movies. Dark or milk chocolate?
Huh?
Milk chocolate or dark chocolate?
Milk.
Okay. Beaches or mountains?
None?
Sasha? Please. Coachella?
Actually, beaches.
Beaches. Okay. Are you a morning or a night person?
Night.
But you love the sun so much. How can it be?
I wake up at 12, and then I shoot in the sunset time, like during the golden hour. Yeah.
Golden hour. Okay, cool. Yeah. Coffee or tea?
Coffee.
What's the first place you'd go to after the lockdown?
LA.
Are you going to take me with you?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Last question. What's the last song on your Spotify playlist? What did you hear last? Or Apple Music?
Enough to Believe by Jamie Jones.
Ooh, okay. I heard Jamie Jones last night. Good. And what's the last movie you watched?
Last movie I watched was the documentary, The American Playboy. Hugh Hefner. Ooh.
How was it?
Amazing.
Yeah. Okay.
That's something which is related to what I'm doing right now. Like how he came up with the idea of Playboy magazine.
Okay. Okay. Interesting. Okay. So Eman, who's our community manager at the Hub, has a question. What event would be a dream assignment for you that you have not yet photographed? Do you do event photography or do you just do model photography or like portfolio? I don't know. How does this work?
I've never done event. I've only done fashion photography, like as in campaigns, catalogs, and some editorials.
What's the difference? If you're doing event, do you have to have a big team and you have to be running around everywhere versus if you're doing...
I've never really thought about event photography. So I didn't go in depth.
Maybe one day you'll be covering the Oscars. Who knows? Okay. So we have Chestmika Govind who's asking, ma'am, I'm looking nice. Can you do a photo shoot?
Of course.
Tanya says, cute. Sasha, I feel motivated. I love you. 100. When was there a photographer teacher in BIS? Riddhi's asking.
Remember,
there was a guy with curly hair and he used to have the camera on his neck always. We have a question, important question. Lights, camera by Shruti. How can I get a portfolio done by Sasha Jairam?
Write an email. We'll write back.
What's your email?
SashaJairamPhotography@gmail.com.
Okay. One second. I'm going to put that up. I forgot to pin your comment. Sorry. I'm new to this, so I make some silly mistakes sometimes. So that everyone who joins, we're talking to fashion and fine art photographer Sasha Jairam. I've pinned her name up here. You can follow her after this on Instagram. She has some insane, her entire portfolio is on her feed. Veena joins. She says, I'm your dad. Big fan and you. I guess you're a big fan of your dad and you. Are you owner of Jairam?
About me.
Are you the owner of the sweet shop?
What?
Someone says, are you the owner of Jairam Sweets?
No.
Yeah, I would know if you were owner of a sweet shop, I think. Okay, let's see. Guys, if you have any questions about living in Bombay, breaking the glass ceiling, those are the kind of questions that you should ask Sasha. Okay, what is the cost, Sasha? Do you want to tell us what is the cost of a photo shoot? Or should we not answer that?
Write an email.
Okay. I'm going to be a model soon. Pritika Pavani says. Okay, we'll see. Zed says amazing. Hi, Zed. I'm just going to read out a few more comments on with our questions. Hi, Sashu baby. Tanisha Bagne.
Okay.
I have more questions, so I'll ask until someone else comes up with a good question. Are you single? They're asking, Sasha. No, I think that one was... How did you come up? Okay, yeah. Perfect transition. Who is this? Pujita, you're doing my job for me. How did you come up with the FaceTime series? What the hell is it about? And how did you manage to come in the newspaper when you're under lockdown?
Nice one. So, FaceTime series, one of my friends on Instagram sent me like an Italian photographer doing FaceTime series, and he's edited all the images so like with his graphic design skills, which is so me. If I was not a photographer, I would definitely take up graphic design because I'm so into it.
Okay.
And then I was, so he sent me the pictures on Instagram. I was like, you know what? What am I doing this quarantine except eating and getting fat? You know, so that's why I was like, let me execute it.
Mm.
And I started editing for content. So, it's not the new photography or something. It's not the new normal.
Yeah, it's not.
You never know.
I agree with that. So walk us through the process. What happens when you're doing, what is FaceTime photography for someone who doesn't understand? And who have you done it with so far?
FaceTime. So get someone online, whoever you think you want to shoot. FaceTime shoots are not really, it's basically brushing up your direction bit and you're brushing up the framing bit and also composition. So you kind of like also, it's like, I just feel like this is not photography. This is just creating new content. And then I edit, I brush up my graphic design skills, Photoshop skills, you know, it's related to photography, but it's not photography.
You kind of keep that whole process alive so people don't forget and get out of the flow of it. Is that why? Is that like one of the reasons or not really?
Sorry. I didn't get it. What?
Like, it's just keeping everybody, it's like reminding them of the process, like posing and like, keep the whole, like, what you would normally, simulating a photo shoot since you can't be in person.
Yeah.
Do? Touch and like, just do something.
Yeah, nearly living the virtual life, you know. So take advantage of it.
Yeah, why not?
And what's the harm in trying something? I don't even get the haters where they say this is not photography. But it's not photography. No one even said that this is photography. This is just creating content, guys.
Yes, I couldn't agree more. I've been making stupid content 3 times a day.
Yeah. Okay. And I feel like there's so much engagement. My Instagram was stuck, literally. And I feel like it's opened a lot of doors also, you know?
Yeah.
So many people are doing it. And I'm happy they're doing it.
Yeah, and it's not about who's doing it first, who's doing it here, there. Yeah. It's just about being open to experimenting, right? So it tells people that you're someone who look for new trends. That's a good thing. Okay, tell us some of the people you've worked with on this. Have you done it with only one person? Have you done it with a few people? And what's been happening?
I've done it with a lot of people, actually. By now, I think I've finished 12 people.
Did I miss the email from you where you asked me, because I didn't get a notification?
Come with your bathrobe on tonight. Come with your bathrobe on tonight.
With my bathrobe on, 100%. Yeah. Okay, so who have you done it? Tell us, give us some names, man. Come on, spill some beans.
Oh, names. Who did I do it first with? I can't think. Ananya. Ananya's went all over the place and I'm just like, wow. And Ananya, Tanya, Alvia, all the people which Gen Z loves.
What is Gen Z for people that are watching? Because like, I'm a millennial, so I don't know what this Gen Z thing is.
You're not a millennial.
I'm a millennial. I'm 26, yo.
Yeah, you're a millennial. I'm talking about Gen Z is... which is more psychotic than us.
So, I think we're all combined into a new category. It's called Gen V. The virtual Gen V.
Yeah.
That's my kind of thing that I keep. Yeah. Okay. Let's read a few more comments. So, Kevin, Kingris says, hey, Sasha, just feel free. Okay, I'm not reading that one. Sasha, you're so cute. Sasha, you're doing a great job. How do you get a portfolio by you? Sasha, is there a ghost in your area?
Sinan. That's a Sinan comment.
Yeah, that is. That's your friend. Okay.
Yeah.
Then, this is a good question from Ankita. Where does your creativity and imagination come from?
Traveling.
Oh, I second that. What are some of your
Netflix series and YouTube music videos?
YouTube music videos, yeah. Like Taylor Swift
like
and all
90s
these
guys. 90s rap, you know, like 90s hip hop. That's where half my styling inspo comes from.
That's cool. What are some of the coolest?
When I first started photography, I used to style, do the models, makeup, hair, everything by myself, you know.
And now how does it?
Now, 90% of my shoots are done by Shimul Styling. And makeup, hair, 90% is done by Ridhima and like Lemmy. And what else? Nothing.
So I know Shimul. So talk to us a little bit about like the process of working with other people, someone doing styling, someone doing hair, you're doing photography. Who coordinates all of this? How important is it to like, everyone to be on the same page and share the same vision, because ultimately, like, you just get one photo, right? The audience doesn't know all this shit that's gone on behind the scenes.
I swear to God, I've tried to curate a team which is so like-minded. It's never happened for like 3 years, but now it's all, I feel like when you don't try, it just falls into place. I found Shimul not because I was searching for her. I found Ridhima not because I was searching for her. It just happens. While you're working with a lot of creatives, you just pick your favorite and do it like loyalty.
Yeah. Loyalty. I know you. That's so important to you.
Yeah.
So since we're talking about this, explain to us, how does the process work? Okay, so you're a fine art celebrity photographer. In terms of business, walk us through as an entrepreneur. How do you get clients? Does a brand approach you? Does a model approach you? Do you approach them? And then what happens?
So basically, Instagram has been an amazing platform for me because I find it like the digital portfolio, which is open for anyone and everyone, you know. So, and I started posting all my work every day, kept my audience engaged every single day, and I realized half of my jobs came through Instagram. And then obviously the more you start working, the more you start working with different kind of people, you kind of get better
word
jobs.
of mouth,
Or,
like word of mouth. In the so it's the same thing even in the fashion industry in Bollywood, like your work's for itself and then good work being.
And nothing, like my dad has no connection with Bollywood whatsoever.
No, so that was my next question. Sorry to like put you on the spot, but everyone talks about how it's so hard to break into this, the Bollywood industry. It's like notorious for it, right? As a girl from Bangalore, from Shimoga, how did you break into that entire film industry world? I mean, that's not gone. There's no way that was easy, right?
No.
And the reason I'm asking, Sasha, it's not to say you've done an amazing job, which you have, but it's to inspire other girls and guys that are in Bangalore, that maybe anywhere in India, that are thinking, I can't do this, you know?
Yeah. So for me, I think it's all my confidence. I feel like I am really not scared to talk to anyone, really. I don't get scared to talk to anyone. And I feel like it's all about personality, you know. My dad always told me, less talking, more doing, you know. That's where I got. And I feel like I didn't give a shit about my accent. I didn't give a shit about my anything. At one point, I feel like the bullying helped me a lot to come out of the shed. You know,
no, I've heard this a lot because it toughens your skin at an early age. And then
Very early age,
you take a lot of shit later on in life, right?
Yeah. For, I really am not scared to face anything.
Trust me, I've seen it.
Yeah, you've seen it. You've always seen it. People, that's the thing. I feel your personality speaks for you. Yeah.
Okay. So that's awesome. Any advice for like young people trying to break into photography? Do you like question that would come to my mind is, are there barriers to entry? Like, oh, I need to already have worked with someone famous, or I need to have an expensive camera, or I need to know how to edit Photoshop. Can they start with an iPhone?
Yes, they can start with an iPhone. There's no end to creativity. Even if you shoot anything on an iPhone, do it. But do it. Start somewhere, you know. And I feel like 90% of the people just talk. They have so many billions of ideas, but they don't do anything about it, you know. And I take risks. What's there in not taking like a risk? Tomorrow, okay, fine. You do something and it's not according to the norm. But still, according to you, I feel like what I did, so for example, nudes was such a big thing in India, right? So I took the risk to do it. And I don't come from a family where I was not restricted. I was restricted, but I said, don't look nudes in a, I don't know how do I say this, like
there's a thin line.
Yeah, there's a thin line. I find skin very beautiful. Like I love shooting skin. You know, and I love working on skin. So that's my genre. And I'm unapologetically, like, I'll tell you this, just take the risks. Anything is a risk, no?
I agree. I think that's such good advice, especially when you're starting out. Because what is your downside? You have nothing to lose.
So many people are so scared about what people will say, think.
Yeah.
For what? You don't need to give anyone any validation, no?
I couldn't agree more. Okay, I have a... okay, let's take some audience questions, actually. Sorry, I forgot about them. Surya says, what are you doing this time to keep... What are you doing time... Crazy.
Surya, you don't know English?
But do you want to answer that?
What? What's that question? I didn't understand.
Okay, we'll take another... What inspired you to start photography that you...
I've already finished that. Surya, ask me something.
Yeah, your questions are a little late to the game. Have you joined this live late? Okay. He asked another question. Is Ananya Pandey fun? How was it working with her?
She's damn cute.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, that's the answer, Surya. I'm sorry.
She's damn fun also.
Okay, we have another interesting question about Shimmel.
I like easy people.
We have an I wanted to know this. Shimmel, from being a dentist to being a stylist, talks about it too. What do you have to say about that? Shimmy, Shimmy, are you here?
Shimmel, I think she is here.
Okay, answer. From being dentist to being a stylist?
She just didn't want to be a dentist. And I feel like even if she changed her profession when she was 25, and it's never too late. If you're not happy, please change.
Yeah. No, she went from styling teeth to styling the full body. So it was just an extension of what she was doing. We have one more question from Ashna. Ashna says, when you travel, Ashna loves to travel. So, of course, when you travel, what are the essentials you take with you for an impromptu photo shoot? Good question.
I've never taken my camera while I'm traveling. I've always shot through iPhone. I've always, always gotten framing ideas through an iPhone.
Okay. Always. So, see, you don't need fancy equipment to, especially on the go. Okay, fine. Oh, we have a positive comment I'm putting up. You're making Bangalore super proud. More love. How cute. Okay, since she gave a good comment, we'll give her a question also. Please tell us more about your sun-kissed photos. Pujita.
What do you want to know?
I don't know what a sun-kissed photo is. Is it when the sun is just kissing you on the cheek or something?
Like me. It's kissing me right now.
Yeah, so tell her more about like the importance of it, or how can other people do it? I guess that's what her question is.
What do you want to know? It's basically, I kind of like natural light photography. I feel like there's a different essence to it, you know? I've never really liked lighting and stuff. Like, I started with natural light.
And Your skin
looks so much better. It's not, I feel like the next generation really likes real, you know?
Raw.
And I feel like that's my genre anyway. So,
yeah. So, okay, so I think what she means is like, what time is the best for light? Is it morning, afternoon? What angle should it hit you? Stuff like that, without giving away all your...
When I first started photography, I used to shoot early mornings. I used to start from 4 a.m. sometimes. And then I used to do like 4-5 shoots a day back 4 years back, that was. But now I just stick to evenings. I start from, say, 4:30 to 6:30, according to the season also.
Okay. Riddhi has a question. What is your opinion on models who prefer shooting with a lighter shade of foundation? Is this... I don't even know what this means.
By the way, I never shoot my test shoots with makeup. I just spray some bronzing oil on them.
Okay, I have a very, very good question from Defender. He says, will you organize any workshops on fashion photography? Have you ever thought about that, Sasha?
Yeah.
And have you ever done it? Or do you think someday you will?
I don't... That's the thing. I don't want to talk about it until I do it.
So you want to get more legitly established, learn enough, and then start, you know?
There's something coming up after this bloody pandemic.
Appreciate that. Okay, then we have another question from Simran. What editing apps do you use?
Snapseed, VS Code, Facetune, and lots more actually. There's this cool app now. I used to use it in uni. It's called Glitch. Check it out.
Okay, guys, check out Glitch. And you can DM us at the Hub Bangalore and let us know if any of these work for you. We'll let Sasha know. Okay.
Yeah.
Darshan Desai. Wow, my man.
What is he asking? How do you handle models with huge egos and who are flexible? That's one. And I've never dealt with a non-easy person, by the way. I've always worked with, luckily, I've always worked with easy people.
Guys, Sasha has such a personality that even if someone with an ego comes up to her, they'll melt because of the vibe. They either gel with her or they're in trouble.
I just don't talk to them after. Simple.
Okay. Arya asks, what's your favorite photo shoot destination? Even I want to know.
Photo shoot what? Destination.
Destination.
Istanbul. So much candy.
That's cool. Were you on hot air balloons? Were there any hot air balloons involved in the shoot?
That's not in Istanbul, Azan.
Oh, sorry. Never mind. Take it back. Okay, we have another question. Sasha, I'm going to... you tell me when you want me to stop questions, okay? But like people ask
me... No,
so...
go on. I'm loving it now.
Okay. Tell us something about Shimoga. Do you speak Kannada? If yes, banter in Kannada.
How do?
What? How do? Give some more.
Banter. Dude, I speak proper Kannada with my... You speak to me, I'll speak back.
Oh, no, Kannada. Let me say this now, I'll get into trouble. Solpa gottu, Kannada solpa gottu.
See, that's broken Kannada. I'm from proper Shimoga, so... I properly speak.
I love my state, but I don't know the language very well. So don't say one sentence. No. Okay. Oh, this is a. Okay, say the sentence first.
Azan, let's skip it.
Okay, fine. Could you recommend? This is a question I wanted to ask. Janvi asked, could you recommend any books on photography? It inverses it. So what is that? Is it H-O-R-S-T?
Now? Oh, it's the same shit.
Yeah, it's mirrored. So just read it out, no?
Horst. Horst. Okay. Photographer style.
Okay. What is it about?
And this. Vanity Fair, 100 years.
Okay, awesome.
Yeah.
There you go. You have two books from Sasha. Style Maria says, hey, Sasha, love your work. Hope you're well. And hi, Azan. Arya here. Oh, this is Arya from BIS. I wanted to ask you, Sasha, since FaceTime shoots are very in right now, what do you think of it? I think, Arya, you missed the beginning part where we spoke about this. But at the end of this live, it's going to be on our story for 24 hours. So you can check it out. Janvi says, please share them in your stories. Sasha, will you share those two books in your stories or should we share it in the Hub story so people can find it?
I'll send it to you. You can share
it. Okay. You send it to us, we'll share it. Okay, cool. Yeah. Tushar Singh in the house, he says, Re.
What Ray. Do you mean? Ray, Ray.
Okay. Let's see what else is there. Ooh, Vikram. He's our chief storyteller. He has a great question. Top three
world-renowned
Good one.
Christian Schuller, David Bellamy, my favorites are these, and Mario Testino.
Okay, guys, there you have it. Top three photographers that y'all can also be inspired by. Let's see what other questions we have. Surya has another good question. What are you doing to keep busy other than photography?
I've not touched my camera in so long. I cook.
What was the last thing you cooked?
Last thing we cooked was spaghetti. Aglio olio.
Very creative.
Easy, very... but...
that speaks that talent doesn't... travel across different fields. Even the best photographers don't know how to cook sometimes. Okay. What else are you doing though, Sasha? Like you're watching stuff, you're doing all these virtual shoots and you're cooking. That's all.
That's all. What can I do?
That's true.
What do you do when models don't cooperate during a shoot?
She makes them look bad in the shoot.
Simple. No.
What do you do though? Is there a trick?
That's what I'm trying to say. I've never been in a situation, no, like that. Yeah.
Oh, this is a good question. Have you done any shoots with any Kannada actresses?
Kannada actresses, I don't think any.
Okay, we have another question. How is it working with Kajal Agarwal?
She's sweet. Was good.
Okay, and we have another question. Who is your favorite photographer from India? I don't know if the ones you named, if they were from India or not.
Farooq Chotia.
Okay. This is a good question. I would have gotten to ask. Honor, thanks for asking this. So,
How long does it take to complete a photo shoot? It depends. It depends. Like my test shoots, I finish them in 45 minutes sometimes.
Wow.
Because it's so not planned. I really don't flow. I have what I want in my mind. Like, I know, like, I collect a lot of inspiration. I'm always on Pinterest. So, I know what I want in my head. So, I just call the person who I want to work with. And then we share the inspiration and we work. We just flow. But otherwise, if it's a commercial job, usually it takes longer. Like, around maximum, my work is 8 hours straight.
Okay. That's interesting. Can you tell us a few cool people that you've worked with? Can you give time to name drop a little bit? So people know, the ones who don't know, don't follow you already.
Cool people I've worked with. Easiest to work with is actually loads. But my favorite to work with is Jackie. Gabby, Shibani, Anusha, so many actually.
Okay, awesome. Another thing which I always wondered is, are people the same on the camera and off the camera? Do you see?
No one looks the same, dude. No one looks the same.
Man, the personality wise, like when you photograph people that act in movies, no, they're different. Yeah. Good answer, dude. I'm happy you said that.
Everyone has a different personality. On camera, off camera.
Okay. I have two more questions for you. After that, I'll let you go. One is, at The Hub, we're building a digital community platform for creative people. What does the word community mean to you?
Community to me is where like-minded people are in the same space.
Mm.
And I've always liked the idea of artists supporting other artists, you know. And I feel like when there are like-minded people, they're always learning from each other.
Mm.
And there's no end to learning. So that's what a creative community, according to me, is. Yeah.
Awesome. Okay, last question. Guys, there are too many questions in the audience, but I don't want to take too much time. So I think we got enough audience questions. Last question from me. What is your message to everyone that's stuck at home, that's in lockdown? What do you want to tell them to kind of get them through the next few weeks?
Work on your websites, work on your Photoshop skills, work on your... Take pictures of whatever, roads, make film out of nothing, you know. Start clicking something, like do something. I feel like, I feel like people who are always on the phones or like on the computer, it's just going to mess up your mind. Like,
balance between consuming blindly and also creating and like going and experimenting.
Yeah, okay. But I feel like keep creating.
Keep creating. That's such good advice. Sasha, thank you so much for coming on live. I'm so happy.
Thank you.
Stay safe. I'll see you soon in Bangalore.
How do you end it?
I'll end it. Don't worry. Should I let everyone look at you for 5 minutes blankly before I end it? Or should I end it now?
Bye.
Bye.